called a softening. Our Jason Carroll's in Austin. He joins us now with the latest. So we talked to Kellyanne Conway about this softening. What are you hearing about it, Jason?
Well, first of all, let me tell you, we were just mentioning Senator Jeff Sessions, and just a short while ago, Anderson, I spoke to him before he took the stage, and I asked him this question about something that Donald Trump had said earlier today, where he talked about possibly softening his position on illegal immigration. And let me give you the proper context. He was asked a question specifically about those illegal immigrants who are living here in the United States society, possibly, where he talked about possibly softening his position on illegal immigration. And let me give you the proper context. Softening his position on the legality of illegal immigration. He was really parsing his words, Anderson. And when he was pushed further, even Senator Jeff Sessions said, this is something that, quote, Donald Trump is still wrestling with. So very clearly, this is an issue that Donald Trump is going to have to deal with. Illegal immigrants living in this country, then it evolved to, I'm just going to deport the bad ones. Then it came down to, well, I'm going to do much of what President Obama is already doing. We expect him to address that particular issue here tonight. He's not going to give an immigration policy speech.
Isn't right, something you do not hear very often, but what that shows you is that this is a position that the candidate is still evolving on. I mean, when you talk to the campaign, what they will tell you is that what Donald Trump is doing at this point is talking.
And tonight, there's no doubt, there's certainly more that we've learned about this dispute. Both sides reacting to a new AP report on the percentage of private individuals who did these two things, give to the foundation that met with Secretary Clinton. We'll have more on that, of course. We'll listen to hear if Donald Trump speaks about this. No doubt he will, because it definitely fits into one of the Trump campaign themes of really focusing on the Clinton Foundation. Let's listen in.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. I am so happy to be back in the great state of Texas. Thank you. Thank you. The people of Texas are proud. They're independent and they are free. There is no better place to deliver the message I have to deliver tonight than right here, right in the middle of freedom. On November 8th, a very, very important date, we are going to declare our independence from special interest, corrupt politicians, and we're going to bring our jobs back. We're bringing them back to our country, and we're going to create millions of new jobs. We are going to declare our independence from politicians who don't listen to us and media executives that don't care about us. And by the way, who never report our massive and very, very friendly crowds. That's for sure. We are going to declare our independence from rising crime, soaring poverty rates, and crushing debt.
We're going to continue to monitor this. We're really particularly looking for his comments on immigration tonight, because that is really one of the main headlines of this evening. We'll bring those to you. I want to bring in, though, Jeff Zeleny, who's joining us now with the latest reporting on the Clinton Foundation and reporting by the Associated Press. What did they find, Jeff?
Anderson, in a nutshell, this Associated Press report says that more than half of the people who met with Hillary Clinton as Secretary portrayal of how often she crossed paths with individuals connected to charitable donations to the Clinton Foundation. The data, he says, does not account for more than half of her tenure as Secretary of State. Anderson.
Now, Donald Trump, how has he been reacting to this AP report about the Clinton Foundation? Because it certainly comes at a very good time for the Trump campaign. This is something they have been focusing on now for the last several days.
It does indeed. I mean, Donald Trump and his running mate Mike Pence have been calling for the Clinton Foundation to be shut down. So tonight they are using this story to fire up their supporters as another example suggesting what they believe the Clintons are corrupt. Trump says this is evidence of pay for play. But important to point out, we have no evidence of that in our own reporting here after going over thousands of emails, and of course there are some more emails still to come here. But there's no question it creates at least the appearance of conflicts. And for the Clinton campaign, that's another headache here in this ongoing controversy. But tonight, a State Department spokesman also told CNN that donors to the foundation actually do request meetings. They're interested in global affairs, humanitarian affairs. So they say there's nothing unusual or improper about that. But in this political context, this gives fresh meat to the Trump campaign, and I suspect he will use it tonight.
Well, I guess one of the questions to be determined is, you know, do they get these meetings because they're donating to the foundation, or do they get these meetings as people do? Department, and are they requesting these meetings specifically through the Clinton Foundation, who then, you know, the Clinton Doug Band guy who works for the foundation contacts Huma Abedin and gets the ball rolling that way. So a lot still to be learned. Jeff Zeleny, thanks. The panel is back. Also joined this hour by Washington Post political reporter Philip Bump. How important is this? Because it certainly plays into the narrative that Donald Trump and Mike Pence have been hitting hard.
Right. No, that's exactly right. I mean, one of the things that Hillary Clinton didn't want to have happen is to have the tone of the campaign shift. We saw right before the conventions that the FBI came out and was talking about her emails, and her numbers sank as a result of that. She doesn't want to see that happen again. I will say, though, that in terms of how bad things could be for Hillary Clinton, this is a fresh story. I think this is probably not that bad over the long run, simply because it's the Clinton Foundation. There are a lot of gaps in that AP story in terms of who she met with and what the relationship was. I think that Donald Trump would be in great position here if he himself hadn't started taking contributions, because one of the things this shows is how sausage is made in D.C. It's an ugly process. It's always been an ugly process. Donald Trump would be much stronger on this if he could also say, I'm not even taking money.
Well, also, I mean, Paul, you guys look so much alike. and I said this to Kellyanne Conway. I mean, Donald Trump gave, by the foundation reports, more than $100,000, or at least $100,000 to the Clinton Foundation. So was he also, if it was pay to play, it seems like, was that part of why he was giving money?
Right, and Kellyanne told you, well, his motives were pure, but these others weren't. And I read the AP story, and I'll let the campaign fight with the AP over the methodology. It's not my business. 12 of the 40 paragraphs in that story, though, were devoted to Hillary meeting with Muhammad Yunus. Now, I know about him half of my life because he's a friend of
the campaign has come forward and said, look,
but it's 12 out of the 40 paragraphs in the story. I'm not cherry picking, Anderson. It's the plurality of the analysis of the AP. This is a man who's probably